Hey guys, so I just got update 2020.8.1, so if you're interested in the new features, stay tuned. Hey guys, so I just got 2020.8.1, which is the newest update, and so I thought I'd go over the features. So the first new feature is third-party charging stations. So basically what that means is if you go on your map, if you go to superchargers, like it'll tell you the supercharger locations and all your third-party chargers. So I'll show you a demo in just a second. Okay, so let's say we're out here in SF and I don't know where the superchargers are. You hit the supercharger button here in the bottom right. It'll tell you where all the superchargers are. So that's like A and B, so the big one in Daly City. But then it also has, you'll see these smaller ones, so that's supercharger 2, but like E, F, G. And so if you hit one of them, it'll tell you, all right, this is an EVgo at Whole Foods, has two connectors, 50 kilowatt power max, you know, and so it tells you, so basically this update basically tells you all where the third party chargers are. So if you hit any of these, so this hotel, Park Central, has one connector at 16 kilowatt max power. And so that's what this update is. So basically they've added all the third party chargers to the supercharger map, which is super helpful because, you know, you don't just charge at superchargers, you can charge at other places too. So, you know, if there's somewhere that's closer and you can pull up the map this way, it just makes it more convenient for you. Next one is Bluetooth improvement. So basically it says to improve the audio transition from phone to car when entering the vehicle, Bluetooth now connects to your paired phone only when you're sitting in the driver's seat and all doors are closed. So basically it's just a different way to, it's just, you know, makes Bluetooth a little bit more, I guess, convenient for you. So basically it doesn't get all fouled up and stuff like that. So, you know, it just makes it a little bit nicer. And it says if you're not connected to Bluetooth, you can hit this button up here to get connect and add new device. Improve voice command reliability. So basically, says we have improved voice command reliability, including the areas with poor connectivity. So basically it's just when you hit this, the right, button over there, it just, they've done some adjustments, I guess, internally with the software. Basically, you can say things and the car will understand you better. So that's all the updates from mine because I have a mid-range, but there are a bunch of other updates too that aren't on my car. So if you have like a P3D, which is a big one, there's some big updates for that. So I'm going to go over those. So let's start with driving visualization. So basically, if you have hardware 3 and you have FSD, we've been seeing recently that those have been, you know, coming out to US owners, where basically if you bought FSD, now people are starting to get the messages where it's like, hey, you know, hardware 3 is ready for you. We can install hardware 3 so you can have full self-driving once it's fully available. And so basically with that, you get, you know, you'll see like stop signs and things like that. And the lights will actually change, garbage cans, cones, things like that in the visualization area. And so this is now available for more regions, not just the US now. So if you're in another country, maybe Europe or somewhere like that, stay tuned. So you might be able to get Harbor 3 pretty soon. And another big one for the Model 3 is track mode. So it's like version 2 track mode, basically, is what they've been calling it. And so basically what it does is it gives you more data and it gives you more things you can do with the car if you're doing like a track day. So basically it'll monitor your car's motors, the battery, brakes, and tires, and allows you to adjust all this stuff in real time. It has a G meter and a real time accelerometer that you can view in the cards as well. It also has a lap timer. Let's see. You can basically start, you can put points on the map for start and finish. So you can do that lap timer. You can save up to 20 track mode profiles to suit your preference in driving scenarios. You can add new settings. You can enter names to those settings if you want, so you can adjust your handling balance, your stability assist, regen braking, post-drive cooling, and compressor overclock. So, you know, if you're a real track buff, this would be a real big help for you to really tune in your car and get all the adjustments you want so you can get the fastest track, you know, lap times possible. Says you can now also save video and data of the track mode driving session. if you have a USB flash drive plugged in, which is pretty cool. So you can actually just, you know, view the entire, track your run instead of just pieces of it. So I'm assuming it's going to be all in one file instead of like doing your dash cam up here and trying to save the whole thing in however many a zillion files. You know what I mean? Yeah. So it is. It says you have to basically create a new file, a new folder in your USB drive called Tesla Track Mode. And, it'll let you save each lap instead of just every minute. So that's really cool that you can do that. So basically you can actually watch, you know, play back your track, lap times if you want. So you can learn stuff from it, try and get better if track mode is your thing. It's also saying with track mode, it also, if you're using your dash cam to record, it also says that it stores the car's status and telemetry data, including details about the vehicle's position, speed, acceleration, and use of accelerator, which is stored in a CSV file on the USB drive. So dang, they gave you a lot of information with this V2 track mode. So if you're a track person, this is going to be a huge update for you. And then basically the only other thing on here, it's just added language support. So yeah, it doesn't say on here which languages, but you know, if you don't speak English as your first language, maybe if you check yours, hopefully your language will be on there. So that might be useful for you. The owner's manual is now also available in multiple languages as well. I'm not going to go over all of them, but again, if English is not your first language, then maybe if you want to read the owner's manual in whatever language you speak as your native tongue, you could do that as well. If you check the, you know, owner's manual and see if there's your language is in there. So that's basically it for this update. It's a pretty decent update, especially if you have track mode. So if you have a P3D, this would be a really nice update for you if you like tracking. The third-party charging stations is really nice too, because then you don't have to use like a third-party app. You can, for the most part, use just the Tesla native, you know, application here and figure out where your destination chargers are if you need them. Let me know what you think about the updates. If you thought this video was helpful, don't forget to comment, like, share, and subscribe. And thanks for watching.